and you are watching Rebel News India. So now, let's have a look on today's top headlines of the day.
The Patna District Administration has identified 47 open grounds and 19 halls where political parties can schedule their public meeting during the Bihar Assembly election, a top state government official said. The number of participants, however, cannot exceed 100 people at such rallies till 14 October, irrespective of the size of the ground.
After a long interval, less than 1,000 COVID-19 cases were registered in the state.
With addition of 983 fresh cases, COVID tally in the state has jumped to 186,690. Altogether, 173,795 people have so far recovered from the virus in the state.
It has not been even a week. Then again one heinous crime came into light in Gaya district.
A 16-year-old girl who was allegedly gang-raped on 29 September at a village under the Koch police station area in Gaya has committed suicide, police said on Saturday. The girl's mother had lodged an FIR with Koch police station on 1st October, accusing three of her co-villagers and another unidentified person of raping her daughter. Police have so far not arrested the accused. Ending a two-day standoff, the administration at Uttar Pradesh Satraj on Saturday reopened the borders of the village that has been at the center of a nationwide outrage following the gang rape and murder of a 19-year-old woman. The development comes on the day UP government officials claimed the special investigation team constituted to probe into the gruesome incident had completed its investigation. Prime Minister Narendra Modi on Saturday inaugurated the 9-kilometer long Atal Tunnel, which connects Manali to the Lahaul Spiti Valley in Himachal Pradesh and drastically reduces the time it takes to reach Leh in Ladakh, saying that the strategically important project was part of the central government's effort to ensure that development reaches every corner of the country. Two-time IPL winning Kolkata Knight Riders captain Gautam Gambhir believes current skipper Dinesh Karthik should bat after Ewan Morgan and Andre Sale, and also wants Sunil Narine to be dropped from the top of the order. The AIIMS Forensic Medical Board, which was looking into Sushant Singh Rajput's death case, ruled out murder in its conclusive report. There were no injuries on the body other than a hanging. There were no marks of a struggle or a scuffle on the body and clothes of the deceased. Dr. Sudhir Gupta, chairman of AIIMS Forensic Medical Board, said.
Thanks for watching Rebel News India. Stay tuned for more updates. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe.